going to discuss on tutorial chapter 7, which is on immune system. So first, we are going to look at for part A on MCQ question. And as you can see here, saya buka juga lecture note lah. Okay, lecture note for us to refer to. Okay. Sekejap. Okay. Number one. Okay, so we are going to look at first for part A, number one. It says here, external defenses against invasion of pathogen include the following except. Ini saya dah buka dia punya, apa? Sekejap ya, saya nak buka yang student punya version. Okay, so for, okay, external defenses against invasion of pathogen include the following except. Okay, so as you know, external defense, it is the first line defense. Okay, so for first line defense, it involve a few component, which is kita kita ada skin, kita ada mucus from secretion of mucus from secretion membrane, kan, a membrane, mucus from membrane lah macam tu kan. And then kalau external defenses, that is the first line defense. Okay, first line defense. So kalau kita tengok dekat choices ni, okay, so obviously skin is the answer, cilia and also tears. Okay, so tears, it contains what? It contains lysosome. Okay, lysosome that contains lysozyme, which is to destroys cell wall of bacteria. Okay, so obviously the answer will be D lah. So D is second line defense. Okay, second line defense. Kedua-dua, first line and second line defense ni, Dia kita consider dia sebagai innate immunity. Okay, so innate immunity maksudnya for innate immunity, it protects your body against any pathogen that tries to enter into your body. Faham eh? Kalau third line defense, it protects your body against invasion of specific specific pathogen. Sebab apa? Kat situ dah melibatkan contohnya lymphocyte yang ada receptor against that pathogen. Okay, so third line defense specific pathogen. Tapi kalau first and second line defense, any dia punya mechanism adalah dia it protects your body against any pathogen that tries to enter your body. It is non-specific basically. It's non-specific. So kena tahulah first, second and third line. Okay, first, second and third line. So external defenses is first line defense. Okay. Okay, so next, which statement describe neutrophil and macrophage correctly? Okay, so neutrophils and also macrophage, they are phagocytes. Okay, they are phagocytes that that engulf pathogen. Okay, foreign antigen that that enters into your body. So kalau kita tengok statement ni one by one, kita tengok yang A. Present antigen to lymphocyte, destroy infected or cancerous cell. So kalau obviously tak neutrophil taklah kan, neutrophil it function to engulf, they are phagocyte, okay, they are phagocyte, so memang salah lah. Kalau macrophage destroy infected or cancerous cell, salah. Ini tugas oleh NK natural killer cell dalam second line defense, okay, NK. Kalau dalam third line defense, dia adalah cytotoxic T cell, okay, cytotoxic T cell. So A is wrong. D, engulf invading microbes. So this one is correct. Okay, so because neutrophil and also macrophage, they are phagocyte. Okay, they engulf the pathogen. And then kalau yang untuk macrophage, engulf invading microbes and present antigen to lymphocyte. Betul lah. So once macrophage kan, it engulf the pathogen, it becomes APC, antigen presenting cell. The macrophage presents the antigen, okay, using MHC kan, MHC molecule of class 2, okay, MHC molecule of class 2. So ini betul lah. So dia present kepada siapa? Present kepada helper T cell. Faham eh? So helper T cell. So helper T cell is a type of lymphocyte. So betul lah. Okay, so the answer will be B. Okay, so kalau kita tengok yang untuk C ni, release histamine in inflammatory response, salah. The cell that produce and secrete histamine adalah mast cell. Okay, mast cell is located in your tissue. Okay, at the infected area. So histamine contained within mast cell. Okay, so once mast cell releases histamine, apa kesan dia? Dia akan menyebabkan contohnya vasodilation. Okay, more blood flows to that infected area. So salah lah. Okay, so produce antibody to destroy pathogen, salah. What is the cell that produces antibody? It is B cell. Faham? To be specific, dia adalah plasma cell. Okay. So D, provide future immunity against invasion by the same antigen. Provide future immunity adalah memory cell. Okay, memory cell. Tak kisahlah dia memory B cell ke, memory T cell ke, memory helper T cell ke. So this memory cell is produced, okay, and will be used during secondary immune response. Okay, secondary immune response. Ingat ya, ada perbezaan antara second line defense and secondary immune response. Secondary immune response dalam acquired immunity. Kan, bila dah acquired immunity tu dah diaktifkan, faham tak? Dia dah aktifkan B cell, dia dah aktifkan T cell. So dia akan menghasilkan yang kita cakap hari tu, clonal selection. Okay, clonal selection. So let's say lah kita ambil B cell. So B cell is activated. Okay, so the B cell will undergo cell proliferation. Dia akan membahagi dengan banyak. So dia akan undergo next adalah clonal selection. Dia akan menghasilkan dua clone, effector cell and also memory cell. So effector cell pada first line, sorry, primary immune response. Okay, effector cell dia akan bertindak pada pada situasi yang kita namakan sebagai primary immune response, effector cell. Tapi kalau memory, secondary immune response. Ada perbezaan ya, secondary untuk bila to protect your body against infection by the same pathogen in the future. Faham eh? So, awak kena tahu beza kat situ eh? Primary immune response. Ini by effector cell. Okay. Effector cell. Second adalah secondary immune response. Ini by the memory cell. Okay, so memory cell will be stored in the lymph nodes. Okay, in the lymph nodes. So, salah lah, that is not the function of a neutrophil. Future adalah memory. Okay, so stimulate immune response by activating B cell and also cytotoxic T cell. Stimulate immune response by activating B cell and cytotoxic T cell. Stimulate ni by siapa? Cytokine released by helper T cell. Okay, cytokine released by helper T cell bila dah ada interaction antara helper T cell dengan macrophage. Okay, dengan macrophage. Okay. Okay, so next, number three, an antigen is a glycoprotein that, okay, kita tengok eh, identifies the own the body's own cell. Identifies the body own cell. Salah. Okay. So siapa yang nak identify ni? So ini adalah kita namakan ni kalau body own cell ni self antigen. Kan? Self antigen which your immune response will not attack. Okay. Tapi in this case, kalau antigen yang kita nak refer ni selalunya antigen that is from the foreign molecule that will trigger your immune response. Okay. So B lah saya dah bagitahu jawapan dia. Trigger an adaptive immune response. Adaptive immune response is third line defense. Okay. Third line defense. Okay. Yang melibatkan B cell, T cell. Okay. So that is antigen. Antigen of pathogen or any foreign molecule that enters your body that triggers your immune response. It triggers the activation of T cell and also B cell, okay, to be activated. It triggers the activation of humoral immune response and also it triggers the activation of cell mediated immune response. Okay, itu akan kena tahulah kalau ada dua dalam adaptif ni kan. Adaptif kita ada humoral immune response. Okay. Ini melibatkan apa? B cell kan? Second adalah cell mediated immune response. Ini melibatkan cytotoxic T cell. So kedua-dua ni, humoral and also cell mediated has to be activated dengan syarat ada interaction antara APC dan juga helper T cell. Kena ada. Okay. Ada interaction antara macrophage dan juga helper T cell. Sebab apa? Nanti akan helper T cell ni akan release cytokine that activates B cell and also cytotoxic T cell. So B lah betul kan? B betul. So kalau kita tengok stimulate lymphocyte cell division during immune response. Salah. Okay. Ini salah. Ini adalah by cytokine. Cytokine released by helper T cell. D is produced by B cell to help the immune response. Ma, ini salah lah. Bukan antigen. Kalau produced by B cell adalah antibody. Okay, not antigen. Okay, B cell to be specific, dia punya effector cell kita namakan dia sebagai plasma cell. Okay, so plasma cell ni yang akan secrete antibody that will circulate in your body fluid. Kalau dalam nota awak tengok ya, dalam nota awak ni nak cakap apa pun tadi saya dah lupa. Kalau dalam nota awak, antibody ni dihasilkan oleh plasma cell. Plasma cell adalah effector B cell. Okay, ha, so itu awak kena ingatlah. So kita tengok, move on to question number 4. Choose the correct statement about major histocompatibility complex. MHC ni adalah molekul yang dihasilkan oleh host cell. Ingat eh. MHC dihasilkan oleh host cell dan dia ada dua jenis. Class 1 and also class 2. Okay. So class 2 dihasilkan oleh sel yang akan menjadi APC. Okay. Sel yang akan menjadi APC which is macrophage, dendritic cell and also B cell. Okay. Sel yang akan jadi APC, antigen presenting cell. Tapi kalau class 1, it is produced by infected body cell. Okay. Infected body cell, all cell that has nucleus. Okay. All of the host cell that has nucleus that is infected by the pathogen will present the antigen fragment using class 1. Dia akan presentkan kepada siapa? Dia akan presentkan kepada cytotoxic T cell. Okay. So awak tahu kan cytotoxic T cell dia berfungsi untuk destroy infected body cell. Okay. The function of cytotoxic T cell is to destroy infected body cell. Okay, dalam cell mediated immune response. Saya nak tunjuk. Dalam awak punya adaptive immunity ni, kalau awak tengok, kita ada dua jenis kan. Kita ada humoral immune response. Kita ada lagi satu cell mediated immune response. Humoral immune response, awak boleh juga panggil dia sebagai antibody mediated response. Okay, antibody mediated immune response. Sebab apa? Sebab tadilah dia melibatkan B cell menghasilkan antibody. Faham eh? Melibatkan B cell menghasilkan antibody. Kenapa kita panggil sebagai humoral immune response? Kenapa? Sebab apa? Humoral ni dia adalah term yang digunakan untuk refer kepada body fluid awak. Okay? Blood, lymph and also interstitial fluid. That's why we call it as humoral immune response. Dan lagi satu istilah adalah antibody mediated immune response, sebab apa? Menghasilkan antibody. This antibody, once it is produced and secreted by B cell, okay, it will circulate in your body fluid to find that specific pathogen that are found in your body fluid. Sebab apa? Dia adalah specific kan? So antibody yang terhasil ni akan circulate in your body fluid to find that specific pathogen to attack. Faham eh? So itu adalah, ni saya note sikit eh. Humoral sama juga dengan antibody mediated immune response. Sebab apa? Dia melibatkan effector B cell atau kita panggilkan sebagai plasma cell. Okay, to secrete antibody. Nampak tak? Antibody kan? Sebab tu nama dia antibody. Secrete antibody that will circulate in your body fluid. Blood, lymph and interstitial fluid. So ini kita bagi dia sebagai humor, body fluid. Okay. So benda ni benda yang sama. Cuma humoral immune response adalah istilah yang digunakan dalam buku rujukan Campbell. Okay. Antibody mediated immune response, istilah ni digunakan diambil daripada buku rujukan Solomon. Okay. It refers to the same thing. Okay. Okay. Itu baru saya cerita pasal MHC kan, belum lagi pada soalan. Okay, so choose the correct statement about MHC. Number one, you see here, kat sini, consists of two pairs of peptide chains. Salah, ini dia refer ke, ini sepatutnya dia adalah structure of B cell receptor ni. B cell receptor ataupun structure of antibody. Antibody, it is protein kan, it is made up of polypeptide chain. Okay, so salah. So it does not refer to MHC. B, divide into clones of effector and memory cell. Salah lah kan, that is not MHC. Okay, effector, divide into effector and memory cell, Memory cell refer kepada B cell, T cell. Once it is activated, dia akan jadi effector dan juga memory. Okay, effector untuk primary immune response. Ingat eh, effector untuk primary immune response, memory untuk secondary immune response. Okay. C, synthesize the liver and synthesize in the liver and circulate in your in the blood plasma. Salah. Okay. D, a protein that binds to antigen fragments and displays them on the host cell surface. Betul lah. Kan? Host cell ni can be macrophage. Host cell ni can be infected body cell. Okay. So if the host cell is infected body cell, dia menggunakan class 1. If the host cell is macrophage, dia menggunakan class 2. Okay, faham eh? So the answer will be D. Okay. Number 5. It says here, which of the following statements describe humoral immune response? Again, humoral melibatkan B cell. Ingat eh, semak dalam fikiran awak, humoral melibatkan B cell yang akan menghasilkan antibody towards that specific pathogen. Okay, so kalau kat sini statement yang pertama eh, selected B cell multiply rapidly, betul lah. Sebab tadi saya cakap dia melibatkan B cell, faham? Okay, so B, statement number one betul, correct. Number two, okay, plasma cell release antibody into the blood, betul lah. Blood is body humor, body fluid, betul. Plasma cell adalah effector effector B cell, betul, kan? So the statement B is correct. Okay. C, memory cells confer immunity to pathogen never encountered before. Never salah. Never tu untuk first line, untuk primary immune response. Kan saya dah mention tadi, memory cells terlibat dalam secondary immune response. It protects your body against pathogen that that enters your body for the second time or third time, the same pathogen. Okay. The same pathogen for subsequent protection against invasion of pathogen, against the same pathogen lah, kan? So kalau tengok kat nota awak ni, tengok definition untuk primary and secondary immune response ni. Yang ni, okay. Primary immune response, okay. Peaks about 10 to 70 days after initial exposure to pathogen, response is lower. Secondary immune response peaks about 2 to 7 days after subsequent exposure to the same antigen and the response is faster. Same antigen. Kalau kita tengok kat sini, memory kan dia terlibat dalam secondary immune response yang untuk protect against the same antigen. Okay. Kalau kalau effector, dia terlibat dalam primary. Okay, untuk exposure to the pathogen that first enters into your body. Okay, never, your body yang dia tak pernah jumpa. Tak pernah jumpa, so dia akan activate kan yang dia akan menghasilkan effector. Okay, menghasilkan effector. So yang ini salah lah, memory untuk to protect against same pathogen, same antigen. Bukan never, never untuk effector. Okay. First line, primary immune response. Primary immune response, ingat eh. Ini primary immune response. Melibatkan effector. Ini melibatkan memory cell. Okay, memory cell will be stored in the, contohnya, lymph nodes. Okay, lymph nodes. So, number tiga salah. So, number tiga salah. Okay, nombor satu dan dua betul. So, C salah. So, jawapan dia adalah B lah. Okay. Jawapan dia B. Kalau C, kalau nombor empat ni, effector cell release protein that form pores. Okay. On the surface of infected cell. Yang ini bukan melibatkan humoral. Ini melibatkan, form pores ni melibatkan cytotoxic T cell. Okay. Cytotoxic T cell will find infected body cell dan dia akan release two kinds of chemical molecule. Yang pertama adalah perforin. Okay. So perforin is to form pores. Okay. On the plasma membrane of infected cell. Second molecule yang dia akan release adalah granzyme. Okay, so granzyme, apa fungsi granzyme? Granzyme ni, bila pore sudah terhasil, okay, ini let's say lah, this is your infected body cell kan. Infected body cell, so akan ada infected body cell ni akan present antigen using class 1, MHC class 1, okay, MHC class 1, okay. So ini infected body cell eh. Okay, so nanti akan datang cytotoxic T cell. Okay, cytotoxic T cell with receptor that matches with the antigen being presented. So ingat eh, class 1 is presented by infected body cell to attract cytotoxic T cell. So bila dah ada interaction ni, nanti akan ada molekul yang kita namakan sebagai CD8 akan attach, kan? CD8. Macam itulah interaction dia. Kan? CD8. Okay. So, nanti bila dah ada interaction antara cytotoxic T cell dengan infected body cell, cytotoxic T cell ni yang pertama dia akan release perforin. Okay, perforin. Perforin is to form holes, okay, on the plasma membrane of infected cell. Lepas tu yang second molecule yang dia akan secret adalah granzyme. Okay, granzyme. So granzyme ni bila bila cytotoxic T cell dah menghasilkan granzyme, so granzyme ni will enter into the infected body cell through the pores that was formed lah by the perforin. So dia akan masuk. Okay, dia akan masuk. So dia akan induce what? Satu istilah ni kita namakan sebagai apoptosis. Okay, apoptosis ataupun cell suicide ataupun program cell death. So apa kesan apoptosis ni? Dia akan menyebabkan infected body cell ni akan musnah. Okay, it forms, it will be destroyed. Okay, it will be destroyed, and once this infected body cell is destroyed, dia akan expose kan pathogen. So maksudnya pathogen ni is deprived of host cell untuk dia reproduce lah. Faham? So pathogen ni bila infected body cell ni dah musnah, so dia tak boleh nak reproduce lah. Faham eh? Dia tak boleh nak reproduce. Okay? Kesan lain untuk cytotoxic T cell ni musnahkan infected cell, so dia akan exposekan pathogen tu. Okay, so pathogen ni dia akan tak boleh nak reproduce. Okay, dia deprive the pathogen of the host cell, of perumah lah untuk dia membiak. Satu lagi, dia akan exposekan pathogen ni kepada antibody. Okay, circulating antibody. It's circulating antibody. So antibody bila dia jumpa exposed pathogen, it will bind and then it will cause the pathogen to be destroyed. Okay, antibody ni kalau tengok dalam nota awak, sebenarnya antibody will not directly kill the pathogen. Okay, fungsi antibody ni, it does not directly kill the pathogen. Fungsi antibody ni bila dia bind kepada pathogen, salah satu mekanisme cara antibody ni destroy pathogen adalah antibody bila dia bind kepada pathogen, dia akan menyebabkan pathogen tu undergo a few situation. Satu adalah neutralization. Okay, neutralization. Second adalah apoptosis. Apoptosis terbagi kepada dua. Satu precipitation, satu lagi adalah agglutination. Okay, precipitation, agglutination and also neutralization. Ketiga-tiga ni bila antibody bind kepada pathogen, so pathogen ni tak boleh nak bergerak, tak boleh nak reproduce. Okay, so bila keadaan ni berlaku, nanti macrophage akan datang and engulf and destroy that pathogen. Ingat eh, antibody does not directly kill the pathogen. It will cause the pathogen to undergo neutralization, agglutination and also precipitation. Okay, so bila ketiga-tiga ni berlaku, salah satu daripada tiga ni, macrophage datang and then engulf. Okay, ha. Itu fungsi antibody. Okay. Ha, tu cerita dah. Tu berkait-kait. Nampak tak? Chapter immune ni dia berkait-kait. Awak kena faham the whole story daripada, untuk third line lah, daripada macrophage sampai dia jadi APC. Daripada APC dia akan attract helper T cell. Helper T cell akan activatekan B cell ataupun T cell. B B cell untuk humoral immune response, T cell untuk cytotoxic, helper T cell juga akan aktifkan cytotoxic T cell dalam cell mediated immune response. Okay, ha, so kena faham fungsi perbezaan antara humoral dan juga cytotoxic T cell ni. Okay. Okay, so yang nombor 6. Okay, kita dah number 5. Okay, number 6. Choose the statement that is not true, okay, about the concept of self and non-self. Self and non-self ni, it refers to self-antigen and non-self-antigen. Self tu siapa punya? Host cell. Okay, host cell. Non-self adalah pathogen punya, foreign molecule punya, foreign molecule that is foreign to your body, that enters into your body. So, supposedly, your immune system, dia nak attack yang mana? Dia nak obviously attack yang non-self. Okay? Your immune system cannot attack self-antigen. Awak punya lymphocyte tak boleh nak attack awak punya sel badan sendiri eh. Kalau if your immune system, okay, your immune cell attack your own body cell, attack self-antigen, it could lead to a disease. We call it as autoimmune disease. Okay. Salah satu contoh autoimmune disease adalah rheumatoid arthritis. Contoh eh, rheumatoid arthritis where antibody attacks joints. Okay, joints at your fingers. Okay, sendi-sendi lah kan. So kalau dia attack your joints at your fingers, it could cause your fingers to be bend or crooked, something like that. Okay, ha, so dia sangat sakit. Okay, so supposedly your immune cell cannot attack self antigen. Remember that. Okay, so kita tengok one by one. Okay, self antigen is found on the host cell and triggers an immune response. Okay, not true. So betul lah, self antigen is found on host cell, dah betul, tapi it will not trigger an immune response. Okay, supposedly, kalau statement ni salah, tapi untuk betulkan dia adalah not trigger. It cannot trigger your immune response. Okay, in this case, soalan dia not true. So, ini lah jawapan dia A. Faham eh? Okay. So, kalau kita tengok yang all the statement, B, C and D, immune system can distinguish from non-self based on the MHC molecule. Tadi saya dah cakap MHC adalah dihasilkan oleh host cell. Okay, so ini betul lah. So, your immune system can distinguish self from non-self because self can produce MHC molecule. Okay, it presents the antigen molecule using MHC molecule. Class 1 and class 2. Okay, so statement B betul. Statement C, activated cytotoxic cell can differentiate self antigen and from non self. Betul lah. Kan, sebab dia tak nak attack, your lymphocyte will not and cannot attack self antigen. It cannot attack self antigen. So statement C betul. Statement D, class 2 MHC found on B cell helps the immune system to distinguish from a self from non self. Betul. Okay, so B cell ni sebab dia boleh jadi EPC, so dia akan present antigen fragment using class 2 juga. Faham eh? Boleh eh? So B cell dia boleh engulf pathogen, becomes EPC, present the antigen fragment using class 2. So dia akan present kepada siapa? It presents to helper T cell. Okay? So number 7. Which of the following statements are true about secondary immune response? Kita tengok dah tadi kan, secondary immune response. Secondary immune response is not the same as second line defense. Ingat eh, beza eh. Second line defense dalam innate immunity melibatkan yang phagocyte tu kan, neutrophil, macrophage, eosinophil engulf the pathogen. Kan, dia melibatkan inflammatory response. Itu second line defense. Okay, dia melibatkan activation of complement protein. Itu second line defense. Tapi secondary immune response melibatkan memory cell. Okay, memory cell that was activated during primary immune response. Okay, that is produced during primary immune response. Okay, so kita tengok statement yang statement dia one by one kat sini. Okay, so yang pertama, the level of antibody declines rapidly. Declines ke? Sepatutnya increase lah kalau tengok kat graf ni eh. Secondary immune response, when you are exposed again to the same pathogen, kan? You are exposed again to the same pathogen, ni first exposure, ni second exposure. Okay, so dengan adanya memory cell ni, your memory cell will immediately, okay, detects the pathogen and then immediately undergo cell proliferation and also clonal selection. And bila dia dah activatekan memory cell tu, dia dah hasilkan effector at that point of infection. So dia akan terus menghasilkan antibody dengan rapid. Nampak tak ni? Rapid production of antibody. So this is antibody concentration, right? Okay. So dia akan immediately produce antibody. Okay. So statement one salah. Sepatutnya produce antibody rapidly during second exposure towards that same pathogen. Okay. So number two, the responding cells are memory cells. Betul lah. Kan sebab dia melibatkan secondary immune response. Okay. Melibatkan memory cells that is stored in the lymph nodes. Okay, number three, response is faster than the primary immune response. Nampak? Response is faster. Kalau when you are infected first by a new virus, contohnya, it takes longer. Sebab tu kalau in case of macam contohnya kena COVID ke kan, ada quarantine 2 minggu tu. Faham? Okay, supaya simptom kena virus tu keluar. Or demam, or batuk, or sesama, dia keluar. Faham tak? Masa tu awak akan demam, okay, awak akan sesama. This is untuk nak menunjukkan badan awak is responding to that pathogen, is activating the humoral and also cytotoxic, sorry, humoral and also cell mediated immune response. Dia nak aktifkan B cell, dia nak aktifkan T cell kat situ. Faham eh? So kalau primary it takes longer time. Tapi kalau secondary immune response, dia punya mekanism dia lebih cepat. Sebab apa? Sebab dah ada memory cell. Tak perlu nak engulf, tak perlu nak jadi APC, tak perlu nak aktifkan secret cytokine, nak attract helper T cell lagi, faham tak? So kalau primary, it takes a longer time sebab badan baru nak respond to that a new antigen or new virus. Tapi bila dah ada memory, terus. Memory tu dia akan take, dia punya effect lah kat situ. Okay? So kalau, okay, so statement nombor dua betul. The response is faster than the primary immune response. Betul lah. Oh, tengok graf ni kan, response is faster. Kat sini dalam masa dalam seminggu je. Okay, tapi kalau primary dalam masa dua minggu. Okay, dua minggu. Okay. So nombor tiga, the response peaks about 2 to 7 days upon subsequent exposure to the same antigen. Betul eh? Oh, tengok dia punya statement kat sini. Kan? Secondary immune response 2 to 7 days. Okay, after subsequent exposure to the same antigen. Okay, tapi kalau yang first exposure dalam masa 2 minggu lebih macam tu. Okay. So jawapan dia apa? Jawapan dia D lah. Okay, D. Okay, number 8. Okay. Anne is a 3-year-old girl with the following symptoms. Okay, symptoms. Apa symptom dia? Pneumonia, persistent bacterial infection, lack of functional T lymphocytes. Okay. Ini kalau kita tengok hay fever ni adalah contoh allergic reaction. Okay, hay fever adalah allergic reaction kalau tengok punya nota ni. Okay, hay fever. Okay, adalah contoh allergic reaction. Okay, allergies are hypersensitivity responses to allergens. Okay, allergens tu maksudnya sepatutnya allergens tu untuk sesetengah orang dia boleh cope. Tapi untuk sesetengah orang dia akan trigger allergic reaction. Contohnya seafood, pollen, kan ada orang allergic to seafood, ada orang okay, ha, macam tu lah. Okay, so allergen, hypersensitivity, terlebih badan awak respon secara sensitif terhadap sesuatu allergen tu. Okay, ha, macam tu. So, hay fever salah. Okay, cystinuria ni dalam chapter homeostasis hari tu kan, cystinuria ni kan, cystinuria ni nephrons, kalau tengok balik cystinuria, nephrons dia tak ada protein, dia apa, protein channels against certain amino acids kan. Sepatutnya dalam penghasilan urine, amino acids ke protein tak boleh namas, it cannot enter into your urine. Okay, tapi untuk cystinuria ni sebab dia punya protein channel ni ada dysfunction ataupun lacking dekat nephron tu, so protein boleh enter dalam awak punya urine. Okay, itu cystinuria ni. So tak ada kaitan dengan awak punya immune system kat sini eh. So salah lah. Rheumatoid arthritis saya mention tadi, dia adalah autoimmune disease kan. Autoimmune disease yang mana antibody akan attack joints. So salah lah. So jawapan dia D eh. Severe combined immunodeficiency disease. Ini ada dalam nota awak. Okay, ini. Okay. Severe combined immunodeficiency disease. Awak tengok eh. Deficiency. Immunodeficiency. Your body, your immune system is lacking. Tak boleh nak protect. Immunodeficiency. Okay. Inborn ni maksudnya dari disebabkan salah satu faktor dia adalah genetik. Okay, dari lahir memang dah ada penyakit tu. Okay, so result from genetic or developmental defect in the production of immune cells or specific proteins. Okay, so example is this cell, there is this disease, CSCID, severe combined immunodeficiency. Lacking eh, tak boleh. Kurang, kekurangan. Okay. Immunodeficiency disease. So keadaan dia apa? Shortage or absence of B and T cells. The person is susceptible to pneumonia and meningitis and can be fatal. Can be treated by bone marrow and stem cell transplantation. Okay. So ini adalah immunodeficiency. Contohnya kalau daripada sejak lahir disebabkan oleh genetik adalah SCID. Tapi acquired later in life, asalnya orang sihat tapi acquired, itu adalah ni. Okay, develop later. Acquired immunodeficiency, acquired later. Disebabkan oleh faktor-faktor macam contohnya you are exposed to certain chemical. Okay, ataupun virus. Okay, so itu contohnya kalau kena HIV, dia akan menyebabkan AIDS lah. Okay, AIDS. Tapi in this case, pneumonia, persistent bacterial infection and lack of functional T lymphocyte ni. Okay. So dia adalah SCID. Okay. Number 9. An autoimmune disease. Eh? An autoimmune disease is an immune reaction to harmless substance. Salah. A disorder where the immune system attacks body's own cell. Betul lah. Kan yang saya dah mention tadi. Autoimmune disease is when your body terlebih pula. Tadi immunodeficiency kekurangan kan, your immune system cannot protect your body against infection. Tapi autoimmune disease is where your immune system attacks your own body cells. Okay, ha, so jawapan dia bukan B and C eh, jawapan dia B. Okay, B. So kalau tengok yang kat CND, an immune system disorder that leads to frequent and recurrent infection, salah lah. Okay, ini recurrent infection inilah immunodeficiency eh. Immunodeficiency. Okay, immunodeficiency. A result of genetic or developmental defect in the production of immune cells. Ini yang SCID inilah. SCID ni. Ini dia refer kepada statement yang kat sini. Okay. Okay, number 10. Which of the following are typical tuberculosis, TB lah. Okay, batuk-batuk kering tu. Okay. Prevent method. So, BCG, vaccination. Okay. Precaution such as cough etiquette. Batuk tu kena tutup mulut. Jangan batuk kat depan muka orang. Tak boleh. Okay. And then, use a germicidal UV lamps to kill airborne bacteria. Okay, so the answer will be D lah. So, TB ni ada mention dah kat last nota awak ni. Okay. So ada vaksin dia. Okay, vaksin. Kena batuk tutup mulut. So kalau you kena TB, kena isolate. Okay, tak boleh bercampur dengan orang sebab nanti dia senang berjangkit. Okay. So ada juga UV light. Okay, germicidal UV lamps. Okay. So habis untuk yang part A. So moving on to part B. Okay. So for question number one, figure one shows the structure of a mucous membrane that lines the respiratory tract. Okay. Name the type of immune response. So kalau awak tengok kat sini, ini melibatkan body surface kan? Okay, ada cilia, mucous membrane, you ada goblet cell. Goblet cell is to produce mucus. Okay. Mucus is to trap pathogen. Okay, that tries to enter the respiratory system, which is bila awak inhale. So obviously the air that you inhale is not clean. Dia ada pollution, dia ada contaminant, dia ada pollen for example, ada maybe virus from the air that you inhale. So it is not clean. Okay. So your respiratory tract, okay, will have cilia and also mucous membrane. Okay, mucous membrane, you have the goblet cell to secrete mucus. Okay, so name the type of immune response. Obviously, dia adalah innate immunity ataupun first line defense ataupun barrier defense. Okay, ataupun external lah, sama je. Innate immunity, barrier defenses, first line defenses, external defenses, sama je. Okay, either one or mention dapat satu markah. Okay, B, name P. Mana P? Ni P. P cilia lah. Okay, senang je. State the function of P. Okay, so when you inhale, obviously the antigen or the pathogen will get trapped in the mucus secreted by the goblet cell. So once you have the combination of the mucus and the pathogen here, so the function of cilia is to swipe the mucus. Okay, to swipe the mucus. Bila awak inhale, awak inhale kan? So udara yang kotor tu akan masuk. Okay, so your mucus will trap the pathogen. So awak punya, ni saya nak draw sikit lah kot. Tapi tak cantik lah. So this is your nostril kan, you inhale. So dia masuk dalam mulut awak lah. Contohnya kan, so dia masuk dalam trachea. Kan? So trachea ni, dia ada intersection antara sebelum dia nak masuk trachea and also esophagus. Esophagus akan lead kepada stomach kat sini. Okay, trachea akan lead kepada lung. Ini akan trachea ke bronchus, kan? Bronchus ke bronchioles, kan? So bronchioles into right and left lungs kat sini. So bila trachea ni dia dah trap, cilia tu dah trap mucus, so dia akan sweep upward, kan? So dia sweep upward, enter into the glottis, and then dia akan tolak masuk ke dalam esophagus pula. Into your it enters into your esophagus and destroyed by the stomach acid here. Kat situ. Okay, so that is the purpose of the cilia, is to swipe the mucus that trap the pathogen upward. Upward ke mana, sama ada bersin dia keluar ataupun dia masuk telan dia, masuk dalam esophagus to be digested by the acid in your stomach. Okay. Okay, D. Explain how mucous membrane that lines the respiratory tract differ. Okay. Differ from the membrane lining the urinary tract in the female in fighting against disease. Explain how mucous membrane that lines the respiratory tract differ from the membrane. Okay, ini awak kena tengoklah lain kan dia punya mechanism dia. So number one, ini 4 markah kan, 4 marks. So for the first point, it says here in the respiratory tract, the mucous membrane secrete mucus. This is the mucous membrane ni. Okay, mucous membrane secrete mucus. Point number one in the respiratory tract. So in the respiratory tract, the mucous membrane secrete mucus. Markah yang pertama, point yang pertama. Second, what is the function of the mucus? The function of the mucus is to trap pathogen. Okay, is to trap pathogen. Itu untuk respiratory tract. First and second point tu tadi. Okay, 2 markah. Untuk point, this the next 2 point, awak kena explain untuk female pula. Bukan female, dalam urinary tract. Betul lah, female. Female urinary tract. So the function of the mucus secrete in the female urinary tract ni, dia bertindak sebagai antibacterial agent, okay, that inhibit bacterial growth. Okay, it inhibit bacterial growth. And also the acidic urine, kan, the acidic urine that that passes through the urinary tract, it also inhibit bacterial growth. So beza kan tadi, kalau mucus dalam respiratory tract untuk trap mucus, tapi mucus secreted by the urinary tract is to inhibit the growth of bacteria, okay, in the urinary tract of female. Dia bersifat acidic, okay, urine tu bersifat acidic, and the mucus secreted, dia bersifat sebagai antibacterial agent, okay, antibacterial agent. Okay, so yang ini saya tulis key point dia tadi. In respiratory tract, it produces mucus membrane. Sekejap. Okay. Secrete mucus, okay. Mucus is to trap pathogen. Okay. First two point. Markah pertama, markah kedua. Markah yang ketiga untuk urinary tract, okay. So in female urinary tract secretions, which produce bersifat antibacterial agent, okay, antibacterial agent, okay, antibacterial agent, which is to inhibit bacterial growth. Okay, to inhibit bacterial growth. Poin yang kedua adalah urinary tract ni adalah laluan untuk urine juga. So urine bersifat acid. Okay. Acidic urine. Okay. Also inhibit bacterial growth. Okay. Also inhibit bacterial growth. And when the urine passes through the urinary tract, dia ada effect, kita namakan dia sebagai washing, okay, washing effect, okay, it washes off the bacteria that tries to grow in the urinary tract, okay. Urine cleanses or flushes away the pathogen from the urinary tract. So boleh tambahlah kat situ. So ada 4 point, ada 5 point saya bagi, dia nampak markah aja kat situ. 2 untuk urine, 2 untuk respiratory tract. Okay, so E, skin is another example for this type of immune response. Okay, so list 3 features of skin that protects our body from invading pathogen. Okay, so number 1, it is intact. Okay, intact, it is ataupun impenetrable. Kalau tengok apa punya nota ni, untuk skin, okay, nampak ni point ni. Impenetrable barrier. Okay, it is impenetrable. It is intact. Number 1. Okay. Number 2, it has oil and also sweat glands. Okay, it has oil and also sweat gland. Kat sini. Oil gland, it also has sweat gland. Okay. So that gives the skin acidic condition. Okay. So this acidic condition prevents the growth of pathogen or bacteria on your skin. Second, the acidic condition akan favor apa, the growth of pathogen. So bukan will prevent, will, it is the home, okay, for normal flora, normal bacteria. Our punya skin ni akan juga home for the good bacteria. So dengan adanya the normal flora, it prevents the growth of the bad pathogen kat situ. Okay. So home for normal flora. Tiga eh. So intact or impenetrable. Second, it has oil and also sweat gland that gives the skin acidic condition. This acidic condition is suitable for the growth of normal flora that prevents the growth of pathogen. Okay. Okay, question number two. Figure to represent part of a cell-mediated immune response. Tadi saya dah mention eh, cell-mediated melibatkan cytotoxic T cell that destroyed, infected body cell, infected with specific pathogen. So, awak tengok je dia punya statement atas, so jot down terus apa yang ingat pasal facts. In this case, is a mediated immune response. Okay, awak tengok kat sini. Antigen, okay, lepas tu ada dendritic cell engulf antigen. Yang ni, dia akan jadi apa? Dia akan jadi APC. Okay, it becomes APC that presents the antigen fragment to helper T cell. Present guna apa tadi? MHC class 2. Okay. So helper T cell is stimulated ataupun dia, when it is stimulated, dia akan secrete cytokines. So the cytokines released by the helper T cell, dia ada tiga fungsi eh. Satu is to activate helper T cell and causes the helper T cell to proliferate, dengan banyak proliferate jadi effector, jadi also memory. Okay, jadi memory juga. Itu first function of cytokine released by the helper. Second function of the cytokine released by the helper is to activate B cell. Okay, ini dalam humoral immune response. In this case adalah cell mediated kan? So dia akan activate kan cytotoxic T cell. So dalam gambar rajah ni lah. So bila activate kan cytotoxic T cell, cytotoxic T cell akan undergo proliferation, and proliferation divide many times. And then it differentiate to form two clones. Satu memory, satu adalah effector. Okay. This is effector. Effector, cytotoxic T cell is stimulated. Okay. Oh inilah, betul lah. Memory kat sini, memory helper T cell. Ni effector lah, betul lah. Okay. So ini, ini belum lagi ni, sorry. Ini belum lagi dia, okay, satu toxic T cell will then will be activated, stimulated is also activated eh. Okay, produce memory cytotoxic T cell, activated cytotoxic T cell, ini baru effector. Okay, ini baru effector. Okay, so effector cytotoxic T cell terlibat dalam primary immune response which is to kill infected body cell. Kill, lice. Lice tu sebab apa? Dah infected body cells akan ada pores kan? And pores, so dia akan induce apoptosis which is the lysis of the infected body cells. Okay. So describe how cytotoxic T cell is activated. Tadilah. Okay. Tiga point. Describe how cytotoxic T cell is activated. So in this case, awak nak kena terangkan sampai kat sini. Daripada atas ni sampai ke kejadian kat sini. So yang saya cerita tadilah. Okay. Kejap ya. Describe how cytotoxic T cells affected cell is recognized by. dah siskin dia punya turutan dia tak berapa nak betul, tak berapa nak sekun sangat. So saya betulkan balik. Okay, so point yang pertama eh. Tadi macam mana cytotoxic T cell dia diaktifkan? Orang kena kena cerita sampai sini lah kot. Sini. Ha sini ni orang nak kena cerita ni. Okay. Yang first one. Helper T cell, okay, stimulates or secretes cytokines, kan? Helper T cell secrete cytokines, okay? The cytokines will activate cytotoxic T cell, okay? Activates, ini helper T cell secretes cytokines. So these cytokines will stimulate ataupun activate cytotoxic T cell. Okay. So this cytotoxic T cell, point yang kedua, cytotoxic T cell binds to infected body cell. It binds to infected body cells. Yang ketiga adalah infected cell is recognized. Sekejap. Kita start again eh kat sini. Sequence. Ni salah ni. Okay, balik semula. Kita start balik semula eh. First, helper T cell secrete cytokines. Oh, dah clear dah. Lepas tu cytokines activate ataupun stimulate cytotoxic T cell. Okay, cytotoxic T cell. Okay, cytotoxic T cell. So, once cytotoxic T cell is activated, dia akan undergo clonal selection. Hasilkan memory, hasilkan effector. This effector cytotoxic T cell ni, effector cytotoxic. Berapa banyak? Okay, cytotoxic T cell will will recognize infected body cell. Dia akan recognize. Sebab apa? Infected body cell will present the antigen using class 1. Okay, using class 1, MHC class 1. So bila dia dah identify, okay, dah recognize infected body cell. So what happen next is that cytotoxic T cell, saya short form eh, cytotoxic T cell will bind to the infected cell, okay, to destroy the infected cell, okay. So that is how it is activated. Sebenarnya saya tak puas hati lah dengan dia punya scheme kat sini. Sebenarnya ini kan, kalau awak nak cerita pasal macam mana T cell ni aktif diaktifkan, dia tak melibatkan infected cell pun. Okay, dia tak melibatkan infected body cell presented by by MHC class 1 ni. Dia melibatkan ni daripada APC ni sebenarnya. Ini sebab saya tengok answer scheme, saya tak macam convince dengan dia punya answer tu. Kita start balik semula lah, boleh tak? I am not convinced with the answer. Macam tu je. Dif, saya buka balik yang baru. Cantik. Okay, kita rewind. Rewind. Kita rewind balik. Sebab saya tak convince dengan dia punya jawapan tadi. Ini sebab saya refer kepada answer scheme juga. Okay. Kita tengok . Tadi, okay, sekarang ni awak dah faham . Okay, figure 2 represent part of cell-mediated immune response. Okay, kita clear. Dia melibatkan cytotoxic T-cell. Okay. Cytotoxic T-cell ni, untuk dia diaktifkan, dia perlukan cytokine released by the helper T-cell. Itu adalah soalan dia. Okay. Describe how cytotoxic T-cell is activated. Maksudnya awak nak cerita daripada awal ni sampai point awak dapat kat sini. Faham . So, maksudnya, okay, sekarang ni awak boleh cerita point yang pertama. Dendritic cell engulf the antigen. Okay. Dendritic cell becomes APC. APC secrete cytokines. Cytokines, okay, will stimulate the helper T cell ni. Helper T cell, it binds to the APC. It binds to the APC using class 2N. It binds to the APC using class, it binds to the antigen that is being presented using class 2 MHC. So helper T cell ni is then stimulated secrete cytokines. So nampak kat sini ada dua kali release of cytokine. One by the APC, second by the helper T cell. Okay, so helper T cell that has secretes cytokines, the function of the cytokine is to activate or stimulate cytotoxic T cell with receptor that complements with the antigen that was recognized by the APC tu. Okay, so cytotoxic T cell is stimulated or activated. So once it is activated, okay, it is activated, it will undergo clonal selection. Okay, selection. So it undergoes clonal selection to produce memory and effector T cell. So once it is activated here, then only it finds the infected body cell to be destroyed. Ha, itu je lah. Kan? So okay, ni cerita daripada sini. Daripada macam mana cytotoxic T cell ni diaktifkan? Daripada APC sampai dia release cytokine. Cytokine aktifkan helper T cell. Helper T cell release cytokine which activates the cytotoxic T cell in the cell mediated immune response. Itu je. Dia tak melibatkan, kalau jawapan saya yang tadi tu, kan, itu cara macam mana, kalau soalan tu dia tanya, how does cytotoxic T cell destroy infected body cell lah. Baru cerita pasal yang tadi dia bind kepada infected body cell. Lepas tu dia secret perforin, granzyme, induces apoptosis. Itu untuk soalan yang macam ni. Tapi kalau soalan yang dia cakap pasal macam mana dia diaktifkan dengan cara yang cytokine ni, mesti awak mention pasal cytokines. You must mention on the cytokine released by APC, cytokine released by helper T cell. Okay? Itu dia. Okay, so B. So what happened to memory helper T cell upon subsequent exposure to the same antigen? Okay, what happened to memory helper T cell upon subsequent exposure to the same antigen? Okay, tadi kan, awak tengok kat gambar ni, bila dia dah terhasil, dia dah undergo clonal selection, dia tu siapa? Activated cytotoxic T cell lah kan, so dia akan undergo memory. So memory ni, dia akan simpan dekat lymph nodes. Okay, for future infection. Okay, maksudnya dia akan bertindak pada masa kita panggil dia sebagai secondary immune response. Okay, so bila when you are exposed again to the same pathogen, apa yang akan berlaku? Mekanism yang yang sama, maksudnya memori ni will undergo proliferation and clonal selection balik semula. Okay, dia akan undergo, it will be activated to undergo proliferation. Okay, to differentiate into two clones, memory and also effector. So memory untuk simpan lagi, faham tak? Untuk simpan, tapi effector untuk bertindak pada masa infection tu. Okay, so what happened to memory helper T cell upon subsequent to exposure to the same antigen? So it will be activated. Okay, it will be activated. Activated memory cytotoxic T cell. Okay, it will become activated memory cytotoxic T cell that undergo proliferation and again clonal selection. Okay, C, memory helper T cell also stimulate other cells upon subsequent exposure to the same antigen. Name the cell. Tadilah sama je, kan? So dia akan hasilkan memory. Memory. Sekejap. Oh, ini dicerita pasal memory helper. Okay. So memory helper T cell. Sorry eh, kita rewind balik. Rewind balik. So it says here, what happened to the memory helper T cell upon subsequence? Oh, dia nak cerita pasal atas ni. Soalan dia, okay, dia nak tanya soalan yang ni kan. Okay, so what happened to memory helper T cell upon exposure to the same antigen? Memory, so dia akan aktifkan, activate, dia akan activate, okay, memory cytotoxic T cell. Okay, it activates memory cytotoxic T cell. Okay, C, memory helper T cell also stimulate other cell upon exposure to the same antigen. Cell apa yang akan dia aktifkan? Satu lagi, memory B cell. Okay, memory cytotoxic T cell untuk cell mediated immune response. Memory B cell untuk humoral immune response. Okay, humoral immune response. Ingat eh, itu fungsi helper. Okay, helper untuk subsequent exposure to the same pathogen, yang memory when you are exposed again, kan, when you are exposed again to the same antigen, so dia akan aktifkan memory B cell, kan, so dia juga akan aktifkan memory cytotoxic T cell. Ha, ingat tu eh, ingat eh, so memory helper aktifkan memory B cell, aktifkan memory cytotoxic T cell during exposure to the same pathogen again in the future. Macam tu. Okay. So number two, what happened to the cell in one, okay, after being stimulated? Okay. So dia nak suruh awak ceritakan apa jadi dekat B cell ni. Apa jadi dekat memory B cell ni. So B cell will be activated to produce effector B cell ataupun dia akan hasilkan plasma cell. Faham? Okay. So dia akan menghasilkan plasma cell. Plasma cell dan secret antibody lah. Kan? Secret antibody. Okay. So point yang kedua lah, kan? So dua point. Satu, dia akan aktifkan B cell jadi plasma cell. Plasma cell then produce and secrete antibody that causes antigen to be destroyed. Okay. Number three, state the type of immune response which involve the cell in C1. C1 ni lah ini kan. So, apa respon dia? Tadilah saya dah cerita kan. Humoral immune response ataupun nama term dia lain adalah antibody mediated immune response. Okay. Number four, give two importance of the immune responses in C3. Okay. Yang ini untuk destroy pathogen that are found in your body fluid. Pathogen that are found in your blood, pathogen that are found in your lymph, pathogen that are found in your interstitial fluid. Okay. And the function of this humoral immune response adalah untuk untuk help. Okay, it helps to protect your body if the second line defense that is not enough to protect your body. Okay, so response to antigen if the innate immune response is insufficient. Okay, response to antigen if the innate is insufficient. Okay, ada insufficient. Dua F je. Okay, insufficient. Okay, tak cukup. Second line defense ni tak cukup kuat untuk protect awak against that pathogen. Then, baru badan awak perlu aktifkan humoral immune response. Okay. Sikit lagi. Okay. So question 3. Figure 3 shows the presence of class 2 MHC on the surface of B cell. Okay, B cell tu dia boleh dia boleh presentkan antigen using class 2 sebab dia boleh jadi APC. Okay. So name R. R adalah receptor lah kan? B cell receptor. B cell receptor. Okay. Give the function of R which is to bind to antigen. Okay. So, dekat sini kita ada antigen. Dekat ujung ni kita ada antigen binding site. Okay, kalau tengok antigen pada receptor of B cell ni, dia ada dua antigen binding site for each one ni. Okay, it binds to the same epitope. Okay, on antigen of pathogen lah. Apa tu epitope? Epitope ni kalau tengok eh. So let's say lah ini adalah pathogen eh. Ini adalah pathogen. Dekat pathogen ni akan ada antigen on its cell surface. Okay. Antigen on its cell surface. Okay. So dekat antigen ni akan ada specific structure lagi. Kan? Several structures dekat. Okay. Ini kita nak, ini adalah antigen. Ini adalah epitope. Okay. So antigen binding site ni yang akan bind kepada epitope ni of the antigen. Okay. So maksudnya virus ni akan ada several different epitope on it. Okay. So this will trigger several B cell to be activated lah kan. It triggers several B cell to be activated sebab different B cell will bind to different epitope on the same pathogen. Okay. So give the function of R is to bind to antigen. Binds to antigen. Okay. C, after B cell is activated, protein molecule will be secreted which destroys the antigen. Name the molecule, antibody lah. Okay, antibody. Okay, so antibody will circulate in your body fluid. Tapi, orang tengok eh, orang kena take note. This antibody will not directly kill that pathogen. Antibody ni tugas dia bukan untuk destroy the pathogen sebab antibody ni dia bukan macrophage. Dia tak boleh nak engulf that pathogen. Dia hanya akan, bila dia bind kepada antigen, dia akan menyebabkan tiga benda berlaku. Satu adalah neutralization. Sekejap. Okay, neutralization. Second is opsonization. Opsonization. Opsonization ni, oh, take note, dia terbagi kepada dua jenis. Satu adalah agglutination. Satu lagi adalah precipitation. Okay, precipitation. Okay. Yang ketiga adalah activation of complement system. Okay. Complement system and pore formation. Okay. So, pertama dengan yang kedua ni, bila pertama yang dan kedua ni berlaku, neutralization, agglutination and precipitation, when antibody binds to that pathogen, okay, it causes the pathogen cannot reproduce, cannot move, they can neutralize, okay. So then macrophage will come and then engulf. Tapi kalau activation of complement system ni and pore formation, bila antibody bind kepada antigen of the pathogen, it triggers complement system to come and activate. Okay, complement system ni adalah sekumpulan protein kepunyaan host cell ni. Bila dia diaktifkan, dia akan menyebabkan this complement system, dia adalah dia terdiri pada protein kan. So protein tu akan masuk dalam a membrane of the pathogen and causes formation of pores. Okay, so imagine kat sini adalah awak punya pathogen kan. So pores akan terhasil. Okay, disebabkan complement system ni, it form pores kan. So dia akan menyebabkan apa? Water and also ions or solute to enter into that pathogen and causes the pathogen to swell and then burst. Okay, swell and then burst. Itu awak kena tengok nota awak balik. Macam mana antibody destroy pathogen? Neutralization, agglutination, precipitation, bawah opsonization and then adalah activation of complement system and pore formation. Okay. So D, give the importance of MHC molecule. Yang macam tadilah, it is to distinguish self from non-self. Okay, point yang pertama. To distinguish self from non-self antigen so that your immune system will not attack self antigen. It only attacks non-self antigen. Okay. So itulah point number one. Satu-satu markah je lah kan. Okay. Ataupun awak boleh tulis kat situ, identifies the body own self, sorry, to identify the body's own cell as self, okay, as self antigen. Okay. So last question, most cancer cell have altered MHC protein. They're altered, okay. So give the consequence of the altered MHC protein on the cancer cell. Okay, so point yang pertama adalah when the MHC molecule is altered, so therefore it cannot bind to the antigen. Okay, MHC when it is altered, it cannot bind to the antigen. So this causes antigen failed to be displayed on the cell surface. Second point. Third point, immune system is not triggered. Hence, cancer cell are not destroyed. Poin yang keempat, awak boleh letak juga, altered MHC increase the growth and invasive potential of cancer cell. Okay. So, itu lah poin-poin yang boleh buat lah. So, bila MHC ni, structure dia dah berubah, dia tak boleh nak bind kepada antigen. Bila antigen tak boleh nak bind, dia tak boleh nak present kat cell surface. So, awak punya immune cell cannot identify. Dia tak boleh nak identify, dia tak boleh nak protect. Faham? So infected body cell is not destroyed or cancerous cells is not destroyed. Cannot be destroyed, okay, by your immune cell. Okay? So, habislah. Habis chapter 7. So far ada soalan? Do you have any questions so far?
Madam, saya nak tanya.
Tanya.
apa red blood cell kan dia tak ada nukleus. Jadi dia boleh ada apa MHC ke? Last one.
Tak boleh lah. Dia tak ada. So so badan red blood cells ni cannot produce MHC and cannot present the antigen fragment. Okay? So it is not